Okay, in the last year, we've seen amazing advances in generative AI. If I give you a text caption, an astronaut riding a horse in a photorealistic style, I can generate these stunning images. Or if I take the caption, an armchair in the shape of an avocado, I can also make the exact chair. What I'll talk about in this talk is other uses for generative models, not just for creating media such as images and video, but rather as a way to give robots imagination. Let's say I want a robot to hop along a trajectory. For example, my text description is a hopper robot hopping. What I can do is I can just generate a trajectory of actions that I want to act in the environment that will synthesize the motion I desire. Let's say I want to stack a set of blocks. What I can do is I can take a generative model and fit it to the behaviors in this setting. It can learn to control the blocks and stack them in a particular order. What I can then do is I can add various constraints on the behaviors I want. Maybe I really want this gray block to be on top of this purple one, and the purple block on top of a red block, and red block on top of a blue one. Now, by sampling from this composed generative model, I can generate these plans that specify exactly the blocks I want to stack. And in general, I can use this to synthesize the behaviors I want a robot to do. Let's say I want to navigate in a maze. I start at the location in the black dot, and I want to go to the location in the star. Simply by generating a trajectory of actions, I can now plan in the setting and generate a path of length 512 in this very complex maze. I can also apply this on the real robot. Here, I have my model takes this image that you see here, and it wants to reorient this T block to the target configuration. It generates a set of trajectories of the actions it wishes to do in the future. And you can see, over time, it gradually rearranges the block to the target configuration. Let's say you want to spread some sauce over this pan. In a similar manner, we can use this, the same generative model now to spread the sauce all over this pan, even if we perturb the pan in various different ways. I can also use the same model to move this mug into a particular 3D configuration. And you can imagine that you can use generative models not only to generate the actions you want to do, but also imagine the future you would like. Let's say I ask my generative model, pick up a sponge and wipe the plate. What it can do is it can synthesize a video plan of the action it wishes to do in the future and use this to act. I can do this for something like, let's say now I have the image on the left where I want to flip the pot upright in the sink. By using my generative model, I can now synthesize these videos of the robot doing this action. And from these videos or imagination, I can get the actions I need to flip the pot in the right way. I can also use this to pick up a metal spoon from the tray. Or we can use this to turn the faucet left. When we think about generative artificial intelligence, the thing we usually think about is they're used to make images, videos, or all types of creative media. But really, generative models are a very powerful tool that can be used across a wide variety of domains. And the domain, and I think one very, very promising setting is the setting of decision making, or the setting of making robots do the actions you want. Your generative model can simply synthesize the actions that you need at any point in time and use it to accomplish the tasks you want. Thank you.